Hello, this is Matthew Chan. Welcome to WebDominationStrategies.com, and I welcome you to my new case study video. In this case study video, I'm going to talk about one of my attorney friends, Oscar Michelin. Now, Oscar Michelin is a New York intellectual property litigation attorney based up in New York City, and I had the good fortune of meeting him 3 years ago. In about the summer of 2008. And basically, his interests and my interests came together when we were discussing the controversy surrounding the Getty Images settlement demand letter situation. And I don't want to get off track with this video. All you have to do is just know that it exists. I mean, there's plenty of information on it, on that situation, which is also a case study in itself. But right now, I want to focus on Oscar Michelin as an attorney who happens to be my friend, but also has a tremendous internet presence. Now, as always with my case study videos, don't take my word for it. Don't even have to look at a screenshot, all right? Just go look live onto Google, and you type in the name Oscar Michelin. And what you're going to find on Oscar Michelin is primarily courtroomstrategy.com, which is a blog that I started for him about 2 years ago, two and a half years ago, and also the website extortionletterinfo.com, which I am the editor-in-chief, but he is also what I consider my partner in crime in terms of him being a subject matter expert. In any case, along with those very prominent listings, courtroomstrategy.com and extortionletterinfo.com, you're going to find, like, LinkedIn. You're going to see some of his entries in Avvo, which is a lawyer evaluation site. You're also going to see a lot of media coverage on him. So even before Oscar ever met me, he had a very respectable internet presence, despite the fact that he did not have his own website. And I bring this up because most people think that you have to have your own big, glitzy website to have a great internet reputation. That is not true. In Oscar's case, he used a multi-pronged strategy. Part of it is that he used media to his advantage, okay? So he would participate in New York media TV coverage and newspaper write-ups, and he would be often quoted. And he was also involved with the lawyer evaluation sites. In other words, he would answer questions posed by people on these lawyer sites. And so that is how I found him, because he had an existing internet reputation. I also found his law firm, which also helped too. But between those three things, really, he already had a great internet reputation way before he met me. But I'd like to say, at the risk of tooting my own horn, that his reputation has been further enhanced by him working with me. In fact, he's my partner in crime in extortionletterinfo.com, where he's the subject matter expert, and where we have a readership that exceeds like 10,000 unique visitors a month. So they know about us, you know, we're known in this little small niche community, and not only has the project that we worked on has netted him a great deal of exposure, internet exposure, and well over 500 new clients, but he's also been able to leverage this into other opportunities, you know. And so what I want to stress to you viewers looking at this video is that Oscar Michelin is a live example of somebody who really is not technically well-versed in the matter, yet because he made some very good choices early on, he had a very good internet reputation. So, as you think about your own situation, in building your online reputation as well as increasing your internet presence, just realize there are many, many ways of doing this. And in some cases, you don't even have to know that one lick of, you don't have to have one lick of technical knowledge to pull it off. It certainly helps, but it is certainly not a requirement. So thank you for listening to this video. Go ahead and type in Oscar Michelin in Google and study that, and you will find out how some of those techniques might be able to be used for your own self. Thank you.